the Bantam Cock. It was a grand upstanding Bantam Cock, so brisk and stiff and spry, with springy step and jaunty plume and a purposeful look in his eye, in his little black winking eye. And I introduced him to my 17 wide-eyed hens. He tucked and he tucked as a hero tucked, then he bowed to them all to the waist, and then he upped and he tucked them all again, he did. And then upon the piece of me ducks and me geese, he rudely did intrude. With glazed eyes and open mouths, they bore it all with fortitude, and a little bit of gratitude they did. Giggling guinea fowl, and he forced his intentions upon my 20 hysterical turkeys and a visiting migrant swan, and the phantom thundered on, he did. He ravished my fantail pigeons and lily-white columbines, and while I was locking up the budgerigar, he jumped me a parrot from behind. She was sitting on my shoulder at the time, she was. Wanted a gasp and a gulp, he clapped his hands to his head, fat bottom back and his toes in the air, the Bantam Cock lay dead, and the vultures circled overhead, they did. What a champion brute, what a noble cock, what a way to live and to die. I was digging in the grave to save his bones from the hungry butchers in the sky, when the Bantam opened up a sly little eye. He gave me a grin and a terrible wink, the way that rapists do. Said, see them big daft burgers up there, they'll be down in a minute or two.